Welcome back to the channel, guys. Today we're going to be working on the supercharged D46. We're going to be changing out the control arm bushings. The other day I was driving and I noticed the steering wheel was pulling a little bit to the right. I took a look at it and I saw the bushings pretty much busted out, so I picked up some new ones. We're going to be changing them out. I'm going to be showing you guys how to do this, so let's get to it. So let me jack it up and we'll see what's going on down there. But another note, paint looks like shit, but new color coming soon. It's going to be a wrap. No more paint. The last guy that painted did not do a good job, so too bad. We're gonna get past this and let's rewrap this thing. But let me get it jacked up here and see what's going on. Also, I'm gonna try to do this without taking off the wheel because all my sockets are broken. It's the only thing that sucks about locks. The sockets are too thin and they crack, so no way of taking the wheel off, but we're gonna try to do it without it. Okay, guys, so this is the passenger side bushing. As you can see, it split, started coming out. I started noticing vibration on the wheel on the right hand side, so I went under it and I took a look at it and I could see it was coming out, so I stopped the car, haven't driven it since. It's time to replace it. This piece was from eBay. I got it like 7-8 years ago, so it did its job, but it's time to replace it for a new one. We're gonna put some rubber ones so the ride's a little bit better. I definitely noticed that the rubber ones are a little smoother. And also, I seem to have an oil leak down here. I gotta figure out where it's coming from. First thing we're gonna do, guys, is probably jack the car up from the center point right there in the middle and get it stand on that side and stand on this side. Once we get it high enough, I think we're gonna go ahead and pull the subframe brace right here. Three bolts, I wanna say it's one in the front right here, one over there, and maybe one up front, so should be pretty easy. Oh, actually, it's two up front, so that should be pretty easy to take that off. And then we should be able to get the bushing off easily. I mean, it's pretty much falling off, so take the two bolts off there and it'll come off. I think putting the other one might be a little bit more challenging, and then the other side too. I don't think we're gonna get into recording that. We'll just do this one and you guys get the basic idea how it goes. Okay, guys, we're gonna go ahead and pull the bolts off of the subframe bracket here. So first thing is always make sure you got plenty of safety. I got stands on both sides. Got the jack here under the control arm just in case, and then my wheels are locked, so we should be good to take it off. Let me get this going. Alright, so now we got plenty of access to the two bolts here. Mine's gonna come off pretty easy. This bushing split, so it's just gonna come right off. Yours is gonna be a little harder, especially if you have the rubber ones, the factory ones. On this side, I totally forgot to mention, we had already replaced this a while back. I totally forgot, so this was gonna be a little hard to get off, but we're gonna knock out both of them, get them both fresh, and I gotta figure out where this oil is coming from because it's getting on everything, so that's something else I gotta check out. Alright, guys, this should come right off pretty easily. There it is, fell out. There's the bushing pretty much gone. So this is what's left of it. So you guys can see this has like a square head, so when you have the rubber ones, it gets really tight in there and makes it hard to pull it out, but this one came out very easy. So let's show you the new ones and we'll keep going here. All right, guys, so these are the new ones right here. That's the old one. Remember, there's a left and a right, so make sure to figure out which one's gonna match this one. So in this case, it's probably this one here. Nope, actually, probably this one. Yeah, so these two are identical, so that's the one we're gonna be replacing on this side, and this is for the other side. So you guys can see in there, it's kind of a square head, not round, so this has a position it's gotta go on once we get it on there. I'll show you guys once it's there. This one has it too. Also, guys, so you can actually rebuild these If you save the bracket, you can put new bushings inside and pretty much rebuild them and reuse them. If you got the time and your car's down and there's no hurry, you can take your time and rebuild them. If you're in a hurry, then just get new ones and get them knocked out. That's what I'm doing here. First thing we're gonna do is clean this. As you can see, it's got a little bit of a dirt grime and it looks like oil. All right guys, first thing I did was clean this. So like I said, just get all the gunk and grime off the end of it right here, and then get it ready for the new part. Let's see if it goes on smooth. We might need to add some lubricant. I don't recommend oil or grease. They say it's bad for rubber, so maybe we'll just put a little bit of soap and that'll help it slide on. And then we'll see if it lines up to the two bolt holes that were good. All right guys, so I added a little bit of soap on the tip of that, and I add some inside the bushing. I just use some dish soap. It'll wash off with the rain or the washes. Also, these have dowels here, so these holes are guided in, so this should help you get them right on there. So let me see if I can put the camera down and get it recorded. Definitely not gonna go in on its own. It's kind of tight, so I'm gonna get the beading on this and get it in, and we should be able to light it. All right guys, so I brought the big boy, Big Daddy Kane here, so get it in. I don't think we need a lot more. It's pretty much all the way in. Just gotta give it a couple whacks and make sure it's seated. So just like that, she's in. Probably flush back here, so that's pretty much all we need. And we should be able to line it up to the wheel. There it is. Holds itself onto the dowels. We'll get a couple bolts there. So this side was pretty easy. Like I said, the other side is gonna be a lot harder, but we're gonna skip through all that and pretty much just get it down on the ground. You guys don't wanna get bored and see the same job twice, so we'll knock it out. So this one is definitely going to probably be a little bit harder. Let me start with giving it some hard wax with the hammer, and hopefully that goes good. If it doesn't, maybe I'll pull the extractor out, but let's see if we can just get it out with the hammer. Alright guys, we had to get a little violent and we had to bring out the fire, but we got it off. And this is the bushing right here, totally toasted. So yeah, we had to get some fire. We can use fire here, make sure to wet the lines here, keep it wet. Alright guys, so I got the subframe bracket cleaned up. Can't even tell it was painted, but it is. So let's put it back on and then with the car, get the car back down on the ground. Alright guys, so there it is, got both of them on. This side took a little longer, but just ended up burning out the bushing, kind of fell apart, but you want to make sure to keep the lines up there wet so you don't get the fuel lines hot. So be careful doing this, but basically that's it. Let's wrap it up. Everybody, there it is, had it all on. Let's drop the car on the ground and then it should be good to drive now. Just got back from driving the car. It's driving a lot straighter and it's not pulling anymore, so I'm gonna call that a wrap. If you guys like this video, give us a like. And also, we guys got some new content coming soon. We're gonna be doing an interior upgrade to this car, so we're gonna be doing some stuff on the inside. We also got an exterior upgrade going on, so we're gonna be wrapping it. Why don't you guys go in the comments below and pick what color you think I'm gonna be wrapping this car, and we'll see what it comes out to be. So if you guys like this video, go ahead and subscribe to the channel, and we'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.